Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our online learning. So what we are going to study on Friday? You are right. Okay, on Friday, we are going to study the listening starter 1 in the first session. And in the second session, we are going to study about Grammar Planet 1. But today, I make some change. Do you know why? Today, we're going to learn these three course books. Okay, Hangout 1. Grammar Planet and the listening. As you can see on the whiteboard, Hangout, Grammar Planet 1 and Listening Starter 1. Do you know why? Because in the second and third session, we will do the progress test 1. That's why today I am going to review all the three subjects for everyone. Okay, first of all, can I ask you a question? Did you do your homework for your teacher? Excellent. So don't forget to submit your homework to your teacher. Okay. So now everyone, please open the textbook in here. Okay. Hangout. Okay, Hangout. Unit 1, we have learned about the school scene. Okay, the school scene. And the remember that we will have the shape inside that lesson. Okay, shapes. What are they? The first one, circle, square, triangle, rectangle. Circle spell C-I-R-C-L-E. Circle. Square S-Q-U-A-R-E. Square. Triangle T-R-I-A-N-G-L-E. Triangle, rectangle, R-E-C-T-A-N-G-L-E. Rectangle. Do you know circle? The round shape, right? Circle. Okay, square. What is square? It looks like this one, okay? The four sides have the similar length, okay? How about triangle? This one we call triangle. How about rectangle? It look like the square, but it's long. Okay, square only this side. Okay, square like this. Okay, and the circle. So these are the four shape. Triangle, rectangle, square, and circle. Do you remember all these four shapes, everyone? Okay, so now let's move on. We learned about the school scene. And in unit 1, we cover 16 vocabulary, right? So let's go through it all together. So first of all, I would like you to open the book on page 10 altogether and tell me what are they, okay? The first one, what is it? Okay, it's backpack. Backpack. Okay, I just read it for all of you and you just repeat after me, and if you still have time, please try to remember about the spelling of the word. Okay, backpack, pencil, pen, eraser, lunchbox, textbook, crayon, pencil case. So it is the 8th word of unit 1. Okay, so let's turn to another page. It's page 15. We're gonna see another 8 vocabulary in unit 1. Okay, so the first one, pencil sharpener, glue stick, ruler, paintbrush, marker, notebook, tape, stapler. So these are all the 16 vocabulary in unit 1, okay, that related to the school thing. Let's move to unit 2. Unit 2, we learned about my toy, right? We also have the 16 vocabulary that related to the toy. So what are they? So everyone please turn to page 20 altogether. Page 20. We will see 8 vocabulary that related to the toys. Okay, so the first one, elephant, cards, jump rope, video game, doll, puzzle blocks airplane. Okay, so these are the 8 vocabulary of the first, okay, the first 8 vocabulary in unit 2. Let's move to another 8 vocabulary. Okay, so these are more 8 vocabulary. The first one, soccer ball, baseball glove, board game, rollerblades, bike, skateboard, kite, hula hoop. Okay, so these are all the another 8 vocabulary in unit 2 that related to the toy. So I hope everyone can remember all these words, because our progress test 2-1 will cover all these 32 vocabulary. Okay, so in Hangout book, we also have the grammar point. Am I right? Okay, so the first one, do you have a stapler? So this question, if you want to know like someone have something or not, you use this question. Do you have blah blah blah? This is the thing that you need. Okay, do you have a stapler? Example, you need a marker. Do you have a marker? Or you want to borrow your friend ruler. So you need to say, do you have a ruler? Do you have a ruler? The answer have only 2, yes and no. Okay, yes for positive answer. Yes, I do. If no, no, I don't. I don't have a stapler. Or no, I don't. I don't have a ruler. You got what I mean? Okay, so the answer have only 2. Yes, I do, and no, I don't. And if you want to make it clearer, you just say, no, I don't. I don't have a stapler. Okay, so let's move to another point. What is it? What is it? Okay, what is it and what are they? These two questions we ask about the thing information, okay, some information or to identify the thing. Okay, the example, what is it? What is it? It is a puzzle. It is a puzzle. Okay, so like example, I ask you, what is it? What is it? It is an eraser. It is an eraser. Okay, so what are they? What are they? They are books. They are books. So why we use these two? We want to know, or we want to identify the thing, right? Why we use these two? Why don't we use only one question? Because the first one, what is it? We use with only the singular noun. And what are they? We use with the plural noun. Like as you can see here, it is a puzzle. A puzzle. So a puzzle is a singular. Okay, singular noun. Okay, what they are blocks. Block here with s. So it is the plural noun. So that is all for the Hangout. Okay, let's move to the Grammar Planet 1. In unit 2 and unit 3 only. Okay, I raised this only these two unit. In unit 2, it's about a this or two digits. We are in this unit, we talk about the singular noun and the plural noun, and we already taught you how to change from singular to plural noun. We have in 2 cases. The first one, add s. So when do we add s? Okay, most noun we add s. Okay, most noun we add s. So the example, 2 boys, 3 books, 10 ball. As you can see here, s, right? S. So we add only s to most of noun. Okay, so why? And then when do we add es? When do we add es? Good question. Noun ending in s, sh, ch, h, or z, we gonna add s. Sorry, add es, not s. Okay, example, 2 boxes, two boxes. So the word box here, the original word ending by letter H. Okay, letter H. Three, this is the original word and ending by SA. See that? Bus, the original word, and that the word bus is ending by the letter S. Okay, that's why we add ES. Can you find another word for me? Another example, like this one. A watch, two watches. Okay, so what else? Can you find? Can you find? Okay, so please sing it more at home. Okay, please try to find it out. So let's move to another one. Unit 3. He is a student. He is a student. So in this unit, we have learned about the pronoun and the subject pronoun and the verb to be. How to use these two together? Okay, the subject pronoun with the verb to be. What is pronoun? Pronoun are words that are used to in place of noun. Pronoun are words that are used to in place of noun. Example, Dara is my friend. Dara is my friend. So I want to use the pronoun to instead the subject Dara. So what is the subject that we can use with that? Dara, he, right? Because Dara is only singular subject, okay? And he is a boy. As you can see, subject pronoun. How many subject pronoun do we have? Excellent, we have 7 subject pronoun. What are they? They are I, you, we, they, he, she, it. I, you, we, they, he, she, it. So 7 subject pronoun. And we also have 3 verb to be. Okay, verb to be or verb be here. Okay, am, is, are. So how to use or how to combine it together? Okay, so subject I, we use with verb to be. Am, you, we, they, we use with are. And he, she, it, we use with is. Got it, everyone? Okay, so again, in English, we have 7 subject pronoun. I, you, we, they, he, she, it. And the verb to be, we have only 3. Am, is, are. Subject am, we use with I, we use with am. You, we, they, we use with are. He, she, it, we use with it. Is, okay? Everyone, do you still remember about the subject you? As what I taught you last time, okay, last video. You, we can use with both singular and plural subject. It depends on the situation that I use that. Okay, like example, I talk to only one person. Okay, only one person, and then I call him or her you. Okay, another situation when I am talking to a group of people, when I talk to them, I will call them you also. Okay, so these are all for the grammar point. I hope you review more and try to practice on the exercise more. Okay, good. So let's move to the listening part. The listening part, we need to practice listen more and more. Okay, so but now today I would like to review some vocabulary for all of you only. Okay, and you can play the track or you can listen to the track by yourself. Okay, because we have a lot of practicing on the book. Okay. Unit 2, we have 6 vocabulary, right? Brass. What does it mean brass? Brass, when the function as a verb, okay, to clean. Brass, like example, brush your teeth, to clean your teeth. Okay, brush your hair, it means to make your hair tidy. Okay, brush, make your hair clean. Okay, go to bed. Go to bed. When you feel like exhausted or you feel sleepy, you need to go to bed. Pajamas. Pajamas. When you, before you go to sleep, you need to change your clothes. And the sleeping clothes we call pajamas. Okay, you wear the pajamas when you sleep. Okay. Wake up after sleep. You need to wake up to do another task like to go to school or go to work, right? Get dressed. Get dressed. Get dressed. Okay. So what does it mean, get dressed, everyone? Okay. Get dressed, to put on your clothes. Okay. Get dressed, I mean to put on your clothes. Okay, so these are the six vocabulary in unit 2. And here, there are the six vocabulary in unit 3. That related to family members. Okay, family member. We have parents, father and mother, right? Father and mother. Brother, family, grandmother, baby, sister. Okay, so again, I'm gonna read these 12 vocabulary for all of you. Brush, go to bed, pajamas, wake up, walk to school, get dressed, parents, brother, family, grandmother, baby, sister. And we also have some question. Okay, so now I raise only a question to all of you. When you want to know about someone's daily routine, like example, what do you do after school? What do you do before bedtime? Something like that. Okay, so now here, what do you do in the morning? So we just add the time expression, okay? The time here, in the morning. If you want to change to another sentence, you just omit it and in place by another time. Like example, what do you do in the morning? What do you do before bedtime? Okay, it can be. Okay, so the answer, I brush my teeth in the morning. Okay, like another example, I ask you, okay, what do you do before bedtime? Okay, your answer must be, I do my homework before bedtime. So these are all for these three subjects. The first one, Hangout, Grammar Planet 1, and Listening Starter 1. And after you watch my video, I hope you learn a lot, okay? And then don't forget to keep practicing on your textbook, okay? So thank you everyone, and I wish you can do the progress test in the second and third session well, okay? Get good score. Goodbye everyone.